Hi, welcome to Uber Micro Repairs. On the Healing Bench today, we have this Xbox Series X. This was sent in by a customer who tried to clean the Xbox out and in the process damaged the Nexus socket. So here we are. I'm not going to turn it on. First thing I want to do is actually assess the damage and then see if it can or can't be turned on, because I might just have to go straight into the repair and see from there. Customer has also stated that they want the Nexus ribbon cable changing as well, regardless of its condition, so we will do that in the process. You guys know the drill. I'll speed run the entire disassembly. Here we are with the main unit out of the shell. We have the front panel and we have the ribbon cable. Looking at this, yes, there is quite a bit of damage to the Nexus socket just there. Let's just put that to one side for a second and just check these out under scope. Here's the Nexus connector on the front panel, which has the eject and power. Definitely been pressed a few times. I think that's okay. Let's have a look closer. Yep, I think he's okay. He can be reused. Connectors A-okay. The cable's been damaged. And the other end doesn't look too hot either. Yeah, that's chewed up and possibly two contacts there look like they may be touching, which is not good news. And it's got quite a severe kink in it. And I've actually straightened that out since. Okay. New connector and new ribbon cable. Let's carry on with the rest of the disassembly. Here we are with the Nexus socket in view, and yeah, there's all the plastic completely removed out of it there. There's just this piece of plastic here. The port does look a little bit damaged, where if you look at these solder tabs either side, they're sort of, rather than being perfectly straight, they're sort of bent, where the whole thing has sort of shifted back a little bit. We have a brand spanking new one here, and yeah, you can sort of see the difference there. So this has got a complete plastic insert. This one has absolutely nothing. So let's get this off, get the new one on, and hopefully we have a working Xbox. So there's the one we've soldered to the board. Looking good, sitting pretty. And then there's the one we've taken off the board. As you can see, that's quite a mess. There's pins floating around in there. All of the plastic comb inside is completely gone. Not a happy socket at all. Okay, cool. Now we're on to reassembly and test. Although the customer's done a fairly good job of cleaning this, I want to make sure that the thermal compound has been replaced and replaced correctly, so I am going to separate these two halves, check that thermal paste. To be honest, whatever's there, I'm going to clean it off and replace it anyway. That's rock hard, definitely needs to be replaced. And there we have the copper heatsink and the APU die, absolutely spotless. I know it's going to drive a few people crazy, but hey ho, it doesn't make any difference whether it's there or not. But all of these little bits in between these caps, filters and whatnot, it really doesn't matter. It really does not matter. As long as the die is spotlessly clean, there's no dust, hair, old compound fibres that are on it, as long as all that's clean, that's clean. That's all that matters. Nice squish. Just a quick note on these X-clamp screws, same for pretty much all of the PlayStations as well. There's no need to screw these down with the power of 1,000 suns, because the more you crank on this, you're not going to get any extra clamping force, because if you look at the screw, there's a stepped shoulder. It only needs to go down to there. So once you feel it bottom out, fingertip tight, quarter of a turn, not even quarter of a turn, tenth of a turn, it's tight, it's never going to move, it's got the correct tension. That's it, done. Also, you may have noticed when I took this off and when I put it back on, I put even pressure in a star pattern, well, loose star pattern. So each of these come up with even pressure, because if you don't and it ends up moving like that, that's how you end up with the corners of the APU being chipped off. I've seen quite a lot of them happen, and yeah, I witnessed someone take one of these off the other day, and they literally just went all the way out with these two screws, and the X clamp was literally at a 45 degree angle, and then they lifted them out as well. Not the way to do it. Here we have the system fully assembled. We've got it plugged in. We've got the capture card here. Just to recap, it was the Nexus socket, which was in an incredibly bad way. Also, they had damaged the cable. We replaced that. We've replaced the cable, and here we are now. So We've got power, that works really well. Boom, we're in. Disc, in, eject. Boom, we're working. So this cable basically just handles power button, eject button, and the LED. So that is a fix. If you need Nexus sockets or Nexus ribbon cables, we have plenty in stock. They're on the site. These cables are quite bespoke, so these are handmade and usually done to order, but all this stuff gets shipped out same day. If you have any issues with consoles, controllers, give us a shout. The link is in the description below, as always. Thank you for watching. Take care.